YouTubers, there's another video to show you the temperature. The white one is the temperature on top of the still, and the temperature is just climbing up now. As you can see, where the white wire runs up to the top of my still, and that's the temperature on the boiler, 85.8. She should be coming out very soon. There, she's just coming out now. So we'll catch all the nasty stuff, about 200 mils. And you can see she's not dripping yet. I've got the little fountain pump running in my esky with water to cool the condensers down. So that's where the water comes into the condenser. It flows through the condenser, through this little pipe, and up to the vertical condenser. It runs through there, on top, and then it flows back into the esky. So yeah, she's just starting to come out now. I'll catch the first 200 milliliters, which is toxic. Can't drink it. I'll turn down the temperature on the boiler a bit on my burner. I've got that turned down a bit. Don't know if you can hear that, but there's just some ceramics inside there with the wash. Temperature is now 86.7. She's flowing pretty strong. So yeah, I've got the one on the left hand side is, I don't know if you can see that, 30.7. That's a reflux condenser's outlet water temperature. That's the temperature on the boiler. And it's still flowing nice and steady. Got about 225 mils. Just catching the heads. This is my little parrot. That's where the alcohol goes in. And it flows through down this tube, down to the bottom, and it goes up to the top. And it overflows there into this little bowl here and through this little outlet pipe and then into the jug just to catch it. And I'll put my alco meter in there. So at the moment she's running a bit hot, so it's currently in about 80%. You can't see that, but it's about 80%. So I'll shut this off. Just close my tap here, and I've got to change the jug while I'm doing the video. So just bear with me. That's the nasty bit. And now we're going to catch the good stuff. And I'll open up my tap again. And I'm going to start turning on my reflux condenser. So this is just a gravity feed watering system I made. That's got a valve on top, water shuttle valve. And it feeds on gravity feed down, a little tap there. And it feeds down into this needle valve to adjust the flow of the water. And it goes up into the column. So yeah, you got your inlet pipe that's coming from the gravity feed water, and then that's your, the other one is your outlet. And the outlet one is just coming from there, and it flows down into this temperature probe there, so you can monitor the temperature of the water coming out. and that just goes into this bucket here. And as you can see, it just trickles down, so it doesn't use a lot of water. It's pretty warm. Currently it's on 71 degrees, the water. The temperature on the column is 82. The ideal temperature should be about 78. As you can see now, the lower the temperature, the more the alkometer starts dripping. If I can try and focus more on that, it's a bit hard to focus. But currently she's sitting on about 75. Nice little stream flowing. She's a bit too quick. Still 72 in the outlet, 81 in the column. I'll just give her a little bit of time to settle down. Still 81. There's a steady little stream. You can probably see the steam coming off the water. I'll turn the temperature. Oh, there she's coming down to 80. I'll give it a little bit more water flow. The ideal temperature to catch at is about 78 degrees for alcohol, so I'll just give it a touch, give it a little bit more water to cool it down. The reflux condenser is actually sitting inside here, just that bit over there. I'll just see how she flows now. She's a little bit stronger now, a little bit quicker flow. We've got about 200 mils now. Get about roughly about 20 minutes per litre. Outlet water temperature is 72.2. The top of the still is 80 degrees Celsius. Currently, we're getting about still about 80% alcohol. I've got to regulate it and give it some more water to bring down the temperature to 78. So I'll just give it a touch of water more. And she's coming down to 79 now. As the temperature drops down, the alcohol percentage will rise. So she's coming down to about 85% now. At 250 mils, sorry, 300 mils we got now. Flowing a little bit stronger. That's my gas burner, which you can see on my channel. It's what we call a crack pot burner or turbo burner. LPG gas, stainless steel keg with a pressure cooker lid. It's just a pressure cooker that's been TIG welded on. Here's all my column, which is about 800 mils long, filled with ceramic and copper mesh, couple of shark bite alloy joints, and now there's no lead and brass. It's been tested. Have a look at my other videos I've got on my channel. There's a test been done on brass. There's no copper, lead and brass, so you don't have to worry about anything. There's the vertical water condenser. It's made out of 20 mil and 12 mil tubing on the inside of it, 32 mil on the outside as the water jacket. And there's my horizontal one, same thing, 20 mil segments, 12 mil, 20 mil, 12 mil, 20 mil, and 12 mil. It's a water inlet coming from the esky and the pump, running through this horizontal one, up through the little tube and up vertical, and then that's the outlet back into the esky, and just recirculates the water, as you can see. Now we'll just have a look at the temperature. Now she's still dripping hose, a little bit slower stream. Water temperature for the outlet is 70.6. The temperature on the column, on the top of the column, is 76, where the probe goes in, where the reflux condenser is. And I'm just going to turn the heat up a little bit, just to get it going a little bit quicker. This is going down to 75. Yeah, we got about, roughly about almost 500 mils in 10 minutes. Currently sitting on the alco meter, roughly about 78. 88%. Trying to get this thing focused, but it wouldn't focus on that. But yeah, she's about 88%. Last 500 mils there. Temperature 77 on the top of the column. And 70.8 on the outlet. Water temperature coming from the reflux condenser. And you can still see the water flowing. Nice and steady little stream. Just trickling. There's a swimming pool bucket, probably about 4 liters. That's roughly about 2 liters in 10 minutes. So I'm not wasting much water. It's all river water I'm using out of the esky just to cool the condensers. So temperature is still 77. Water temperature is 70.8. And 87.9 on the boiler. As you can see there, the river water is pretty clean. That's just gravity feed, and that runs to cool the reflux condenser. Goes up into the reflux condenser. There's the probe for the to measure the temperature on the top of the column, which is currently still at 77 degrees. And I'll give it a touch. A little bit more heat into it. Rise the temperature a bit. Still 77 and 70.9 degrees. And now we've got 600 mils. Still running at about 88, almost 90. Nice steady stream there. This is the heads which I will use for fire lighters. That's the toxic bit. 120 liter esky. Just filled up with river water. That's the return back into the esky. That's a 220 volt submersible pump. That's the outlet of the pump running to our condenser. We're running at 77 degrees. Running pretty good. 70.9 on the waters. Still a nice steady stream. Yeah, I've got a clean jug that I prepared earlier, so when I need to change the jugs, I'm going to change this water. Just emptying all the hot water out of the bucket, and it's just water. Okay, put it back and catch. Alright. So now the temperature is starting to stabilize more. I've got almost got 95% now. As you can see that. She's stabilizing a bit more now. 71.1 on the water, 77 on the top of the reflux condenser, on top of the reflux column. Water still flowing nice. Currently got 900 mils. Yeah, about 95% now. I'll try and get this thing to focus more. That's the 100 mark. The top one is the 100 mark, which is that one there. That's 95. So, we're getting about 95%. We got almost a liter there. And I'll have to stop this video so I can change the jug. I'll carry on assuming as I'm going to be getting ready to change the jug.